Lynn, hoping you can see me. I'm just basically going to run through the Pilates element first, and then we'll go on to the RBT. And rather than do this real time, partly because I am pushed for time, I'm going to put the ideas together, and then you do as many rounds, if you like, I'm talking more of the Pilates now than anything else, as you want to. And as I said before, you need to do the warm-up first, so we'll go through the warm-up element. I'll go through one set, and then if you want to, what I'm going to do later is type it all out, and then you go through as many sets as you like. The other thing is, because I'm going on holiday, I've packed all the music away, so I'm going to do this to silence, which isn't so much fun. And then I'm going to go to what we did with the swimming work and the plank work, and then I'll do a separate little DVD to show you the RBT. Okay, so starting with a warm-up, all your normal muscles, Pilates muscles, need to come to the fore. So we would breathe in, breathe out. When you come to the end of your out-breath, we're going to do that little draw in. And the four bones, at every opportunity you can think of. So then we would breathe in as we raise, out, and then I would nearly always, always put in a shoulder roll. Or four, three, two, one, and then we would go forwards, just to stretch the muscles we've just worked. Inhale up, exhale, elbows are floating, and then four of these, cross lift, retract, cross lift, retract, cross lift, and the last one. Excellent. Make sure you get the groove between the shoulder blades there. Then we're going to inhale up, exhale to knees, exhale, 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 get rid of all the stale air. Inhale, collarbone lifts. I'll show you this one from the side. Exhale, come into a tall cat stretch. So you draw the chin down and you join the tailbone under. I'll come to the mat now. And then I would repeat that little sequence a few times, maybe four times, that little set. And then we need to get to the floor. So we're going to inhale up. Exhale to the knees. And then hands to the floor. And then we're going to go to all fours. So this is the one I wanted you to really practice. It's going to be a mixture of the four exercises we did. So first of all, you're going to rock forward. Do you remember? So we're trying to get the weight equal between our hands and our feet. Four of these, sir, and it's all good anyway. Okay. And then you want to find the place where you're equal weight between your hands and feet. Then we're going to inhale, exhale. Exhale. When you come to the end of the exhale, draw in on the four bones. Pull up the belly button, which should happen voluntarily, more or less. Take your forehead to the floor. Inhale here. Exhale, and we're going to come into a tall cat stretch. If you're ever stuck as to when to inhale and exhale, think where you crunch the tummy, like now, we would exhale to get the air gone. Then inhale into cow pose, where we dip the lower spine, we're looking up, but remember I said not too deep for you. Okay, and then we're going to go to neutral, which is the point between those, so your back is nice and flat. And then the turtle, and I think you could do with maybe four of these, is literally where you drop between your shoulders without moving your elbows. Lift lower. Lift lower. Lift lower. Maybe put in a hug to the upper back and then settle into neutral. Then you're going to take one hip bone to the same side elbow without rocking the femurs to neutral and then the other way. Whew, that's a really freeing up movement. Through to neutral, take the knees out, go back, palms are up, and just relax. So here we do four deep breaths. Every time we breathe out, we're relaxing more and more. So just let the shoulders drop. Let the back telescope. Then after four breaths, take the hands ahead. Inhale, exhale, and we're going to fall into the floor. And that's when we did the lying down swim. Okay, so we relax everything. Inhale,
Exhale, come to the end of the exhale, draw the four bones together, draw the belly button to spine, and then we lift the opposite limbs. And then once you've established that, bring the head away from the floor. Start slow to get the pattern, and then once you've got the pattern, you float everything. So it's quite a demanding exercise. It doesn't look like it is, but it is. You just do the opposite limbs. And you could do more than that if you wanted to. Then I place my hands by my chest, flexing the knees, forehead to the floor, neck in line. Breathe in, breathe out, compress. And push away from the floor in a neat line, and then drop back. Child's pose again, if needs be. If you wanted to, at this point, you can add in the swim on all fours. So just to take you through it anyway, one leg goes back. Breathe in, breathe out, compress, so just drawing the belly button up. Pull the tailbone under a little bit. Lift the leg parallel without losing your alignment to the floor. Take the opposite hand out, and we're going to lift. So hopefully, I'm in pretty much a straight line. You could then take the arm out to the side and forward, or you could thread the needle. Watch your balance there. Take it out again, in, relax. Go to the other side, inhale, exhale, compress. Lift the leg first, arm second. Just to add to the challenge, out to the side, thread the needle, looking through, out to the side again, forward, in and in. So that was really the routine. So go through the warm-up four times. You could go through that second block where we get down to the floor four times, say. And then the other bit I was going to show you, just to reiterate the plank, to get the perfect plank, start completely relaxed. Draw your elbows tight to the body. Inhale, exhale, compress at the end of the exhale. Don't worry about this bit too much because we've got to correct the position. Come into Sphinx, letting the feet drift out. And then to get it neatly into position, we shift back a little bit. Now you're good to go. So, inhale, exhale. Where the diaphragm is most relaxed in that gap. I'm pulling the belly button away from the spine. Oh, towards the spine, away from the floor. And then we're literally going to just scoop up onto our knees. So keep the bottom fairly low. Turn the toes under. And then lift a knee, and you are in plank. Neck in line with the spine. Hold as soon as you start to shake. Knees, hips, chest. Open the palms up. And you're done. And then you can maybe go for another one. Okay, so quality control really matters there. That'll do for the Pilates. I'm going to switch this off and then we'll go through the RBT exercises, what they are rather than the actual real timing. Okay, hang on there.